guess what? A new contact is interested in receiving your newsletter. That's great. So let's take a look at their customer journey from lead to marketing qualified lead, also known as an MQL, to sales qualified lead, also known as an SQL. Your first automation is pretty straightforward. We just built it in the last section. It looks like this. Remember, this automation begins when a contact joins a list. You can have contacts join a list through many avenues, including completing a form or even a manual upload. Let's take a look. Back in the platform, we'll start from the automations page again. You can import the automation easily when creating a new automation. First, click on New Automation. And note the Import Automation button in the upper left. Paste the share URL and click Import. Now we're in the Automation Setup Wizard. This will enable you to personalize the automation shared above. Click Get Started and follow the prompts to personalize. First, it will ask to confirm the name and email address for the first email in the automation. I'll type in my name and click Next. Now it will ask us to set our if-else condition based on the specific campaign, welcome email number one. Click Next. Then we're routed to the next if-else condition and we'll select the campaign for welcome email number two. Click Next. Lastly, you'll specify what lists you'd like them to unsubscribe from in your automation. We'll pick Announcements and News. Click Done. You'll be able to edit all of these options again, but be sure to complete the import process to finish pulling the automation into your account. Let's retitle this automation and make it our own. We'll rename this one Lead Welcome Campaign. Now, what's next? Your contact is ready to learn more about your business, and you want to learn more about them. Our next automation will focus on tagging and personalization. Let's click New Automation and start from scratch. We'll start with the same trigger as before. Click Subscribes to a List. We're going to select people on our Announcements and News list. Click Add Start. We'll send them an email to determine their product interests. Select Send Email from the Sending Options menu. Let's create a new email, and we'll call this Product Interests. We'll go with the personal email template this time. We can make it be from one of our salespeople. Click Use This Design. We'll call this email Tell Me More. In this email, we can place a link to our website we want the contacts to visit, and then we can watch what actions they take. Let's click inside the copy of this email and add a sentence with a link. First, we'll add our link URL. But check this out. You can add an action when a contact clicks a link from inside the campaign builder. You can add or remove tags, list membership, or send them to an automation. For now though, we'll just keep our actions inside the automation builder and keep it at one link. Let's remove the action and click OK. To get back to the automation builder, click Save and Exit. Click on the plus sign to add a wait step. Go to the Conditions and Workflow menu and select Wait. We'll select to wait until conditions are met. In the Segment Builder, we'll select the Actions option and then Has Opened. We'll wait until our contact has opened the Product Interests email and click Save. We'll add a time condition and give them a week to open the email. Now for an if-else statement. If contacts open your email and click the link inside, you know they're more engaged. We'll go to Actions and select Has Clicked on a Link. We'll specify the Product Interests email and we'll specify the link we put inside of our campaign. click OK. If that condition is a yes, meaning they opened your email and clicked your specified link, we'll add a tag. Click on the plus button, go to the contacts menu, and select Add Tag. Now we'll add the tag MQL, or Marketing Qualified Lead. Click Save. On the No path, we'll send them another email and see if they click on the link this time. Click the plus button, go to Sending Options, and click Send Email. You can click on the Edit drop-down menu to copy and edit the email you sent before and modify your content a bit. Instead of a link, let's give them a button to click. We'll delete the link we sent before. Now, let's add a button. Click on the Insert tab in the sidebar and drag the button option into your email. Click on the button to format it. For now, we'll just add our link in the sidebar. We'll also edit our button to say Learn More. Let's click Save and Exit and return to the automation. Now, we'll insert the same wait condition as above, waiting for the email to be opened for up to a week. Click on the plus button, select Conditions and Workflow, and select Wait. We'll select until specific conditions are met. Remember, we're waiting until our contacts open the second email. We'll select the Actions menu and click Has Opened. We'll specify our product interests copy. This email is the copy of the first one we sent. Click Save. We'll add a time limit and wait up until 1 week. Click Save. Now let's add another if-else condition. We'll wait for contacts to click the link in our email. Select Actions and Has Clicked on a Link. We'll select our current email, which is Product Interest Copy, and designate our link. Click OK. If they click the link in our email, we'll add our MQL tag. If they don't click on our link, we'll add a disengaged tag. We don't want to keep sending to uninterested contacts. We can leave them in a general list for newsletter sends, but let's not over-email them. Oops, don't forget to name your automation. We'll call this one MQL Product Interest. And click Save. As a note, you'll find all of the links to these automations in the resources at the end of this lesson. Now we're going to build one final automation. Let's head back to the main automation screen. This automation will incentivize our MQLs and try to push them to SQLs, Sales Qualified Leads. Any contact with our MQL tag from the last automation will receive an email with a special offer, hoping to complete a sale. Click New Automation. Select Start from Scratch. This automation will begin with the start trigger Tag is Added. We'll specify our tag MQL. Now, whenever someone clicks on a link from the last automation and receives the MQL tag, they'll be added to this automation. Click Add Start. We're going to send them an email, MQL coupon. Let's use the webinar template because you can personalize all templates however you'd like. Select Use This Design. We'll use a new subject line, something catchy like Hurry, 20% off and soon. We'll update this headline to say, Buy today and save 20%. We'll delete the things we don't need from this template. we'll move this button up. Let's change the button text to Buy Now. We'll send them to our store. Let's click Save and Exit for now and return to the Automation Builder. All right, let's insert another wait step. We'll wait 1 week for them to open the email. Next, we'll add an if-else condition. Click on Actions and Has Clicked a Link. Select the email and specify the link to the store. If they click on our link in the MQL coupon email and head to our store, we'll give them a new tag, SQL. Click on the plus button and add your tag. Since we're adding this tag, we'll also want to remove the MQL tag from before to reduce confusion. Click on the plus button again and select Remove Tag. Remove the tag MQL. If they don't click the link, let's send them one last email. Click on the plus button and go to Sending Options. Select Send an Email. We'll copy and edit the first email again from the Edit dropdown. We'll try to increase awareness and let them know that the offer ends soon. Let's edit our headline to include that information. Let's save and exit again. We'll insert one more week-long wait step. Now we'll add a final if-else statement. If they click on our link this time, we'll give them the SQL tag. Click the plus button to add your tag. We'll also remove the MQL tag. If they don't click on the link, we'll end this automation. Those contacts will remain an MQL for now, and perhaps a different incentive will entice them in the future. Oh, let's name that automation again. We'll call this MQL to SQL conversion coupon. Click Save. You now have a path for a contact from lead to MQL to SQL. There are so many ways to personalize this journey, and we'd love for you to do just that. Check out our prompt below and reach out to the success team if you have any questions.